What's going on, you guys? My name is Brianna, and welcome back to the channel. I'm trying not to talk too loud because it's literally like 7:30. My dad's still asleep. But anyway, let's go ahead and get into day one of my 10-day green smoothie cleanse by JJ Smith. I am going to be putting a little bit of a twist on my actual journey over the next 2 weeks. So I won't be doing mine for 10 days. I'll be doing it for 2 weeks, so 14 days. So let's go ahead and get to what I eat, what I don't eat, and all of that goodness. So as the day goes by, I'm pretty much just going to show you guys what I eat, what I don't eat. I really won't be eating too much of anything. I'll mostly be doing drinking. So it is breakfast time. So today, this morning, what I'm going to be drinking is my green smoothie. In here, I have strawberries, I have water, I have greens, I have orange juice. So I just got some oranges and I just squeezed the juice out of it. So there's that, as well as bananas, flax seeds, some mangoes, and some apples. And I believe that's everything that I have in this smoothie. So this is my breakfast. This is what I'm going to be drinking during breakfast time. And I did go ahead and taste it last night. So I made my smoothie last night, and then I tasted it just to make sure that I like the consistency of it as well as the taste, because, you know, this is typically what I'm going to be drinking every morning. And I cannot get this top off for JK. Probably should have shaken it up a little bit. But I love the consistency of the smoothie because it's not just like straight liquid. It has a little bit of the crunch, so I can taste the apples. I can taste kind of the chunkier stuff that I put in it. So like the apples, the flax seeds, I'm actually able to chew that. The good thing about my day one is that I don't have to go to work today. I have the day off, so it's a nice way to kind of start the journey and kind of see how the day flows. So yeah, this is my breakfast, guys, and I will come back to you and show you guys what I will be eating for lunch. Okay, I'm back, guys, and it is a little bit before 11 o'clock. It's not yet time for me to have lunch, but honestly, I'm not even like, first of all, let me get in frame. I haven't made a video in so long, I don't even know how to be in frame. This is crazy. It is not yet time for me to eat lunch, but I am going to go ahead and get some water. My mom said the water is really going to help flush out all of the bad toxins in my body, so it's really going to make me go pee as well as poop. But I don't just have plain water. Like the past week or so, I have been putting aloe vera juice. Oop, wrong side. Aloe vera juice in my water. So I'm gonna go ahead and pour a little bit in here. This is my cup. I don't really know how many ounces this is, but does it actually matter? Like, does it matter? Typically, I go ahead and I fill it up with aloe vera juice about that much. I just kind of eyeball it. I don't really do measurements when I pour the juice in my water. Just, it is what it is. Oh, little bit more than I wanted, but it's fine. Literally, once you mix it with water, it just tastes like flavored water. But let's go ahead and we're gonna put some water in there. If I'm being totally honest, it tastes like lemon water. Like, it tastes like lemons that aren't like too sour. So again, flavored water. It doesn't taste like anything super weird. Typically, I would go ahead and I would have a smoothie for breakfast. I would have a small, sensible meal for lunch. And then for dinner, I would go ahead and have another smoothie. So I didn't end up finishing my full bottle of my smoothie from this morning. I probably finished like 2/3 of it, so I still have a little bit left over, and I'm actually like still full. It's been about 2 hours and I'm still kind of full. I'm not really sure if I'm actually even going to eat lunch today. So I had these garden herb Triscuit things. I literally had like 5 of those, but I'm not like super hungry right now. The smoothie was very fulfilling for me, so I don't even think I'm going to eat an actual lunch today. But I also have dinner super, super early. I eat dinner at like 5 o'clock because I have to be in bed by 6, because I do wake up at 2 in the morning for work. Sounds crazy, but it's what works for me, okay? I have a super early shift for work. I start work at 4 a.m. So typically I try and get to bed super early. So around 6:30, I try and be in my bed and on my way to sleep. You know, eat my dinner around 5. So I'll probably go ahead and eat my dinner around 5:15, around that area. So that way the smoothie has a little bit of time to digest. But because it's not like food, and a lot of it is already condensed into the smoothie, it doesn't have to take like 3-4 hours to digest like typical food would, like meats and just, you know, different stuff like that. And I am used to eating a lot of processed food, so typically those things do take longer for me to actually like digest before I go to bed, and I wake up and I feel like congested and my stomach hurts and all that bad stuff. But anyway, I don't have that problem because I am drinking smoothies. Hey friends, so it is just about 4:30. It's currently 4:27. I have Bible study in like literally 3 minutes. It starts at 4:30, so I'm going to try and make this quick-ish, and then I'll come back after, and then I'll kind of wrap everything up. But I'm going and finishing off my dinner. So like I mentioned, didn't end up having lunch because I was still full from the smoothie throughout the day, so all I did was really drink my water that does have the aloe vera juice inside of it. And this is... I literally only had like this much left, so I'm finishing this off, and this is pretty much my dinner. I love how it has like a very chewy texture. Again, I like that it's not all just smooth, so it kind of still feels like I'm eating something. I'm gonna go to Bible study, then I'm gonna come back, and I'm going to share with you guys pretty much why I am on this smoothie journey, why I'm doing it, what the health benefits are for me personally. And just kind of my point of view, and yeah, just share a little bit about myself with you guys. Welcome back, friends. So it is day 2 of my green smoothie cleanse, and I just kind of wanted to wrap up the video a little bit and tell you guys why I am making this lifestyle change. I'm making this lifestyle change because I don't really like, if I'm being completely honest, I really don't like the way that my stomach looks. I used to work out twice a week. It's something that I've fallen off of a lot, so I kind of need to incorporate working out back into just my weekly routine as well. But when I used to work out a couple of times a week, I was like, you know what? I should go on like a fitness journey. So I went ahead and I took a picture. I had on like, it wasn't a crop top, but it was just like a workout gym shirt. So like you could kind of see my stomach, but I had like these, high top biker shorts so I could cover it up if I wanted to. So I went ahead and, I pulled it down and I kind of like took a photo cause I wanted to have like a before and after. And I just was like, is that really what my stomach looks like? Like, that's crazy. Not to mention, and not even just like what I look like on the outside, I wasn't very comfortable with it. So my stomach is always like my biggest insecurity. It always has been, ever since I had like medical problems, like way back when, I was in, high school, I had medical problems. I had ended up losing a ton of weight. I loved the way I looked for like 2 years. But then, what I was eating really started to catch up with me. So then I started to gain the weight back, which was actually a really good thing because I couldn't gain weight for like such a long time. So there actually was a point where I was so insecure because I wasn't able to gain weight. So then I gradually and slowly started to gain that weight, and I was really happy, but I just kept gaining the weight because of all the processed food that I was eating and just, you know, just of course stuff that wasn't good for me. And lately I have been, don't get on my case about this, you guys, but I have been doing some door dashing, to say the least. A couple of days ago, before I started my cleanse, I went ahead and I cleared out all of my DoorDash bags. As you guys can see, I'm a huge fan of McDonald's. Not their actual food, but I love their McFlurries. I love their Oreo McFlurries. I love their M&M McFlurries. Those are good too. I love their fries. Not a huge fan of their nuggets anymore. Anyway, that's that. I just haven't really been making that great of lifestyle choices when it comes to eating. So not only did I not like the way that my stomach was looking on the outside, but lately I had just have not had a lot of like natural energy. Like my energy has just been super low, which is super unacceptable because I run a business and I will be starting a program, a internship slash school program with my church very soon. I'm gonna need a ton of energy for that. I literally wake up at 2 in the morning so I can start my work shift at 4 a.m. And it's just not a good look not to have the energy, especially for the type of job that I now do. Anyway, yeah, I just was not feeling very good on the inside. I went to bed feeling super full all the time, just wasn't really feeling that great. Like, if I'm being completely transparent, I literally looked how I felt most days, and I just wasn't comfortable with that. So I was like, you know what? I think I want to do the green smoothie challenge. Very, very popular. It's been out for quite a while. It's nothing new. But I was like, you know what? I think I kind of want to try this. And this is new for me, but it's not new for me. So my mom is a vegetarian. I believe she's been a vegetarian for probably like 7, maybe going on 8 years now. I know she's been a vegetarian for at least 6 years, maybe almost 7 years now. But every now and then she would give us like smoothies to like cleanse us out if we were like stopped up and we couldn't like poop or something, or just we weren't feeling all that great. She would make us smoothies. So, you know, drinking smoothies every day and not eating certain foods isn't entirely new for me. The hard thing for me personally, day one I was good, but today's day two that I'm wrapping up the video, and I literally got home and I was like, you know, I kind of want some McDonald's fries. But I didn't order any fries, you guys. I promise I didn't. Because I'm standing my ground and I really do want to become healthier. I don't just want to look the part, but I want to be the part. I want to feel the part. And I cannot tell you guys how much energy I have had. And also, my mom mentioned to me that my skin will start to really clear up. And baby, she was not lying. She was not lying. Acne where? Acne where? Literally, my skin feels great. It looks great. It's not picture perfect, but also don't mind my hairline. It's all over the place. But anyway, yeah, I just wanted to do this challenge. And also, typically, this challenge does go for about 14 days. So they call it the, is it 14 days? No, it's 10 days. It's like the 10-day green smoothie challenge by JJ Smith. But I'm actually going to go for 2 weeks. So I will be doing 14 days. Already, I already feel like I have natural energy. I went to bed last night. I wasn't super full. Literally, the foods that I'm eating are fruits, vegetables, beans. So I'll have like wraps and like salads like tonight. I cannot tell you guys how starving I am. Like, it is, what time is it? It's a little bit before 3 p.m. in the afternoon and I'm literally starving. So I'm gonna have my dinner, and typically I do try and eat an earlier dinner because usually I'm in the bed by 6 o'clock, because again, I do wake up at 2 a.m. for work. So yeah, it, like, so far I feel good, I look good, and it's just great, you know? So now I just kind of have to get in the routine of incorporating working out again, which, to be honest with you guys, is going to be really hard because I'm also trying to rebuild my relationship with God and really just finding that good self-discipline, okay? Like, motivation is out the window, because literally you can feel motivated one day and very unmotivated the next. But yeah, you guys, it is, again, it's only day two officially, but I'm feeling good. And I actually need to make some more smoothies. I need to make some more tonight so I have some to drink tomorrow for my breakfast. That is a little bit about my story. That is why I decided to do this. Even after the 2 weeks, 100% I am still going to do the smoothies and like the small portion of like a dinner. So typically I'll have my smoothie in the morning and then I'll have like a salad, or like last night I had a wrap. So inside of my wrap, it was, I had beans, I had some cheese in my wrap, I had lettuce, and I literally think that's it. Like, literally that's it. I'm not having a lot of meat, just because I'm already not that into meat. Like, I don't get super wild over not having meat in a meal, which is a good thing. Yeah, that's me. That's my journey. Oh, also, I almost forgot to mention. So I also did weigh myself on Sunday. So on Sunday, I weighed myself. I started the challenge on Monday, which was yesterday. Just kidding. Yesterday was not Monday. Yesterday was Monday. Sorry, I'm getting my days mixed up, guys. So I weighed myself on Sunday just so I knew what my official weight was. When I started this challenge, I'll probably weigh myself again after the 2 weeks is up. Or I might just wait an entire month to weigh myself, just so I can see how great that consistency really is, because I know you can lose a lot of weight on this challenge, but the ultimate goal for me isn't just to like lose weight. Like, I want to feel good. I want to start eating better. So that is ultimately why I decided to do this challenge, because I want to look good on the outside, but I also want to feel good on the inside. I want to have more natural energy. And just overall, I want to eat better because I do want to live a long life. I cannot live my life off of fast food and a ton of like processed food, because it's really not good for you. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this video. I will catch you guys in the next video. Mwah. Bye, guys.